what Balaam's era is. Balaam's era is essentially the attempt to curse those whom God has blessed. Balaam tried to pronounce a curse of the people of God and failed abysmally, to a point even of ending up dissed by a donkey, because he could not curse those whom God has blessed. However, he was given counsel, or he rather gave counsel, I stand corrected as to how that goes, to curse God's people successfully by causing them to sin and eat food, sacrifice to idols, commit sexual immorality. That was the only time that the people of God could successfully be cursed. So they walked away from God from piety. They allowed a little leaven to leaven the whole loaf, and all that sin enabled cursedness to come on their path. So therefore, it is imperative to maintain a godliness of piety in order that you might not be cursed. And also to understand that suffering is not the tantamount of cursedness. It can't be. Why? Because the Bible made it clear that that's not a thing. Blessed are you when you're persecuted. It's a blessedness. Blessed are you when men revile you. It's a blessedness. Blessed are you when mourn, you will be comforted. It is a blessedness, you guys, to go through a lot for Christ, to suffer for taking up your cross and following Christ daily. That is a blessedness. Do not therefore equate suffering with cursedness. Because God's people can't truly be cursed unless, of course, you're busy fornicating, watching pornography, swearing at everybody, stealing, sabotaging in the office. That, on that day then, will get you lambasted by your next door neighbor, which otherwise you're pretty set.